Well, of course you love Ethan. So do I. But he finds himself in the awful position of loving both of us. And I think you'd want to give the man you say you love the time and space he needs to make his choice.
Oh, don't you dare mess this up, you little gutter snipe. This is Gwen's one chance to show Ethan that she is the one he should spend his life with, not you, Teresa. It's just the idea of dating both of us.
Unless, of course, you're afraid that once Ethan spends more time with you, he'll realize he's not in love with you after all.
All right, just take one step at a time.
I'm scared, Dad.
Sweetheart, you gotta be okay. Just don't look down.
Look, you're doing good, Simone, all right?
Sweetie, you just do what your daddy and Chief Bennett say.
You promise you'll all make it down there with me?
Of course, sweetheart.
There's no time, and you know it.
At least the girls will be safe.
I love you, Dad, Mom, Whitney, Breeze, Sam Bennett. Be careful, Chad.
Oh, we love you too, sweetheart.
Just hang in there, Simone. Easy. It could be a lot quicker if some of us went down by rope. What do you say, Whitney?
That is way too dangerous,
Look,
man.
We don't have a lot of choices, Chad.
Can you do it, Whitney?
Well, yeah, I think so. I'm an athlete.
You just be careful, okay?
I don't see you.
Hey, what you talking about? Look, in a couple of minutes, I'm gonna be right down behind you, bugging the heck out of you.
Whitney, there's no time. Hurry!
Look, forget me killing Sheridan, okay? The moment that fireball hits the ground, we're all gonna be dust.
Help me get down into the mineshaft with the others, without being seen. It's my only chance to survive.
You've gotta be dreaming, Mon Ami. You're on your own.
I want you to go next.
I don't want to leave you, Maurice.
Look, forget about the spirits, all right? I'm not gonna die.
But they said that now that we're finally together that I would be killed. They must have meant the fireball.
Look, whatever they meant, I'm not gonna let anything ever happen to you again. If you never trusted me before, trust me now, okay?
It's me. Why couldn't Julian have just died when he fell in that sinkhole? You mustn't talk like that, not now.
Why?
Because we're all gonna be dead in a few minutes? Well, maybe it's for the best. I don't know how Julian found out that Sam and I were lovers, but now that he knows, it's only a matter of time before he figures out that Ethan is Sam's son and not his. This is not the time to worry about that. You're right. If it's the end, then there's only one thing I want to do. Where are you going? To kiss the only man I love one more time before I'm dead.
Too strong for evil. Charity shall be vaporized in a matter of seconds.
Charity's about to die.
The light's killing Charity. I can't let her die.
No, Miguel, you have to. You don't have a choice. Either Charity dies or the fireball that she launched is going to destroy Harmony and everyone in it. You have to let her die to save the rest of us. It's the only way.
Dim your searchlights, damn it! What sort of morons are they recruiting for the rescue squads, isn't it? Hell. Where's the damned exit? Help! Somebody help! It's Julian Crane and I'm trapped!
Sam, I need to talk to you.
For God's sake, Ivy, not now.
Easy, Whitney.
Easy.
I think it's coming even faster now.
You're right. It seems to be accelerating at 1,000 feet per second. At that rate of speed, it should make contact with the Earth in about...
Reese! You shut up.
Dios te salve, María, llena eres de gracia. El Señor es contigo.
Whatever happens, Eve, I love you. Oh, I love you too. I really do. And if we don't make it, and you do,
don't you worry. I'll take care of the kids. And if TC and I don't make it,
gosh, I don't even have to ask.
That's it, isn't it, Teresa? You don't want Ethan to date both of us because you're afraid he'll realize that his love for you isn't nearly as strong as his love for me.
That's not it at all, Gwen. I know that Ethan loves me. I can see it in his eyes when he looks at me. By the way he relaxes when I walk into a room. I can feel it when he touches me. That's real love, Gwen. And it won't disappear just because you want it to.
That's what you think, you little wannabe. Now, real class always wins in the end.
Look, I think all Gwen is saying is that none of us know what this dating idea will bring. You know, chances are the two of you may get sick and tired of the position I've put you in and end up telling me to go to hell.
Never.
Look, that's nice to hear you say that now. But none of us knows what the future holds. I mean, if you would have asked me a year ago if the three of us would ever end up in a situation like this, I mean, I would have told you it was impossible.
That's because it's always made sense for us to get married.
Well, Gwen, I guess what I'm saying is that in life, you never know what's going to happen. But things happen, and when they do, you have to roll with them. And even change completely if necessary.
Maybe that's true for you, Ethan. But I know what I feel for you will last forever. I'm going to love you until the day I die.
We may see, won't we? That is, if you give Gwen's suggestion a shot. Teresa, don't do this for me. Do this for yourself. I mean, right now you think you know what you want for the rest of your life, but you're still young. Give yourself a chance to think about this. See if I really live up to your dreams. Gwen's going to do it. You know, it may turn out that I don't measure up to either one of your dreams. And then we'll move on from there. So, what do you say?
I guess. What about Luis?
What about him, Teresa?
Look, I'm not trying to upset you, all right, sis? I'm just telling you how it is. Just because Ethan is young and smiles nice for those society magazines, that doesn't make him any less of a sleaze than his father or grandfather. He's even more dangerous because he knows how to charm people.
That is not true.
Look, I know him, and you don't.
Well, it'll never work. I mean, my brother hates Ethan. He'd never let me go out with Ethan in a million years.
Not her, Kay. All right, it's some kind of evil independent making her do these things. Look, I have to find a way to stop it without hurting her.
It's impossible.
Look, maybe I can redirect the light from the box to focus on the pendant instead of her. Look, help me close the lid.
Miguel, there's no time. You've got to save yourself.
I don't care about my own life if I lose Charity. I can't let her die. Please, God, let this work.
Demons of darkness, help us fight the forces of good. Kill the light. Kill Miguel. Where's that bloody light? If that wasn't a rescue squad, then what? Avian.
Dear God!
Pull.
That's all righty, they have
pull
me.
Pull on my name.
Oh, come on. Pull. You got her?
Okay.
Whitney!
She's there, you got her? Oh, there she is. Wait, come on, wait.
Oh my God!
Chad, you can let go. She's okay.
No, no way. I'm never letting go of her again.
So you were never even there.
And the whole thing collapsed.
What do you mean?
Oh, don't look, Ivy.
What are you talking about?
Sorry, Miss Crane, but the mine shafts caved in.
But that's where Julian fell. Julian must have died when that whole thing caved in.
I'm so sorry.
No! My secret about Ethan and Sam, it died with him.
You're not thinking clearly. Your secret no longer matters since we're all about to die anyway.
If we can't get down to that mine shaft, how are we going to get out of the way of the fireball?
Don't look. I need you that way.
I can't lose you now, Luis.
You're right, Teresa, your brother is going to be a problem, but I don't think it's going to be an insurmountable one.
Ethan, how can you say that? Luis will go crazy if he finds out I'm the reason that you and Gwen didn't get married.
I think you should listen to what Teresa's saying, Ethan.
But Gwen, it was your idea to have me date the both of you.
Well, maybe this is a sign. I mean, if Luis would have such a huge problem with Teresa dating you, imagine how he'd feel if you chose her as the woman you want to spend the rest of your life with.
No, but I am not afraid of Luis or anyone else who gets in the way of my relationship with either one of you. I mean, if anything, I mean, this gives us more reason to pursue this dating thing. I mean, it will be kind of a trial for us and our families. I guess the ball's in your court, Teresa.
If you really think it's for the best, Ethan.
Look, I know it sounds unorthodox, but I think Gwen came up with the only fair solution.
Well, thank you, sweetheart. The way I picture it, you will date both me and Teresa alternately, and I think because tomorrow was supposed to be our wedding day, I think it only fair that I have the first date. You don't have a problem with that, do you, Teresa?
Do what you will, Miguel. We'll win in the end.
Let her go, Miguel. If you don't, she's going to destroy us and everyone and everything in harmony.
If I can only defuse the pendant somehow.
It's too strong, Miguel. The only way you're going to save anyone, including our families, is to let the light destroy the pendant and Charity.
Smart girl, if you're on our side, definitely beat the forces of goodness.
I won't do it. I won't hurt her.
Come on.
crap, Mom.
Tim remembers you from the prom boat.
Judas Priest, it's that talking doll again. I must be hallucinating.
Jimmy thought that first too, but this is definitely real.
Oh my God, have mercy, I'm losing it.
Charity, please say something. Charity, wake up! Wake up! Come on, wake up! Please, God, come on, wake up! Wake up!
We're gonna make it, Charity. We're gonna make it together, right?
If only I knew Kay and Charity weren't afraid.
They're with Miguel and Tabitha. I'm sure she's watching out for them.
What the hell?
That's the same light Reese and I saw before.
I thought I'd seen everything.
What's it doing?
I'm not sure, but it looks as if it's aiming straight at the fireball.
But why?
Again, I'm just guessing, but it looks like the light's trying to stop the fireball from smashing into the earth and killing us all. A cosmic battle, if you will.
If it is a battle, it is between the lost souls of the damned and the angels trying to save us. Pray God the angels win.
This, Teresa?
Just think there's got to be another way.
Don't tell me you're afraid you're going to lose your advantage just because I'm going out with Ethan first. I mean, surely you must have more confidence in your relationship with Ethan than that.
You won't stop loving me, will you?
Teresa, it's not fair to put Ethan on the spot like that. Only time will tell which one of us he loves more. That is the point of this whole thing. Remember?
Teresa, don't worry. But I think we've all talked enough for tonight. I better get you home, Teresa.
Well, my goodness. You're all still here.
Rebecca, I thought you left a while ago.
I had to come back and get my purse. So, how was your little talk?
Went pretty well. We decided that the best course of action was for Ethan to date both me and Teresa alternately.
Well, my goodness.
I know it's unusual, but considering the circumstances, we have to try whatever we can to work this through.
And I certainly feel better knowing that we have a course of action, don't you, Teresa?
I still believe true love will win out in the end. As it should. We should go now, Ethan.
Right. I'll call you in the morning, Gwen.
Ethan! Ethan, I really hate to be a nuisance, but because we're dating now, I think it's only appropriate that I spend the night at home. Would you mind dropping Mother and me off after you run Teresa home?
I finally found you.
I told you I wouldn't let anything happen. I'm glad everybody's here that I know, because nobody'd ever believe this.
Now all we have to do is save the others.
Hey,
I'm here, Mama.
Oh, my God. I'm going to do it.
Mom? Dad? It's Kay.
Oh, God. You're alive. Oh, thank God. Thank God.
It's all right. It's all right, Mama. Okay. Are you okay?
Yeah, I think so.
We thought we'd lost you guys when the mine shaft collapsed. How did you guys make it out?
I don't know. Me neither.
One minute we were down there and the next we were up.
Well, don't you remember? I led you all out just as the shaft started to collapse.
Tabitha, I could never thank you enough for saving their lives.
Yeah. I don't remember Tabitha leading us out.
We must have. Did you guys see the golden light?
Oh my God, are you kidding me? It came from this box that was buried down in the mine shaft. Miguel's foot kicked it open by accident, and this incredible light poured out.
What? Where's the box now?
It's still down there. I used the light from the box to disintegrate the pendant around Charity's neck.
Why'd you do that?
Because Charity was gonna kill us, that's why. What?
Hey, why would you say such a thing?
Not just me and Miguel. She was gonna kill everyone with that fireball that she sent up into the air. You guys should have seen her shooting mini fireballs from the tips of her fingers. Kay, I would never do anything like
honey,
that, even
honey,
if I could.
Honey, you don't know what you're saying, huh? You must have hit your head when you fell.
I think you're right. She could have a concussion. I'll check her out.
No, I don't have a concussion. It's true. Miguel, tell them. Charity was trying to kill us. Is this true, Miguel? I don't remember anything.
Of course you don't. Look, the pendant had you in some kind of trance. It's not you that was evil, Charity. It's the pendant.
Wait a second here, Tabitha. Now, what do you know about all this?
Actually, a great deal. It was all my fault.
Bravo, darling. This double dating scheme of yours is brilliant.
It has to work, don't you think, Mother?
Oh, of course it will. I mean, I feigned surprise when Ethan announced the plan, but I'd already heard it. I mean, in no time at all, he is going to realize that there is no way he could seriously consider marriage to the housekeeper's slutty little daughter.
Well, that's what I'm banking on. I mean, could you imagine him taking her to dinner at the club? I mean, I doubt she knows an escargot from an endive. I mean, he'd be so embarrassed by her ignorance, he'd dread going out with her after one or two dates. Looks like Ethan and I will be getting married after all.
Tracy, you don't really think that I would ever stop loving you, do you?
No, Ethan, it's not you. I trust you with my whole heart and soul. It's just Gwen I'm not sure about.
But, Teresa, there's nothing she can do. I know I love you. It's just that marriage is about more than love. It's about sharing things and working through situations that only comes from spending time together. This is the only way I can be sure of who I want to marry.
Well, I am not afraid. I mean, we were brought this far for a reason.
Fate.
And fate will make sure we end up together.
That little snake.
I've been told time and time again, I wouldn't believe it 'cause you were my best friend. But now I've seen you together, I thought you would never break my heart by messing with my man. I don't like it, no, not one bit. This is as low as anyone can get. Glad it's out.
I blame myself entirely. I should have known better than to tell ghost stories round the campfire. I'm afraid it sent our dear young one's imagination into high gear, causing them to dream up these outlandish happenings you're hearing about.
You're not saying that those things really didn't happen down in the mineshaft, are you, Tabitha?
No, we saw them with our own eyes. That pendant that you gave Charity a couple of months ago has evil powers.
You see what I mean?
No, I mean, and Charity was talking in this weird voice. She was saying, like, us instead of I. She wasn't herself.
She had fireballs shooting out of her fingertips. And you and your doll wanted us dead, too.
What, my Timmy doll?
Okay, you're not back on that thing about the doll being alive, are you?
It is. Well, it was, I swear. Charity, you've got to remember all of this. You were the one controlling it.
Look, I don't remember any of this, I swear.
And Miguel, if I hurt you, I'm so sorry.
But couldn't I have just passed out when I fell down into the mineshaft?
Yes, that is exactly what happened, but then we woke up. Charity, don't you remember? We thought Miguel was dead, and then you went crazy and you wanted him to die.
Okay.
See, why would I want him dead? I love Miguel.
I don't care what you say now. I saw the whole thing. There were dozens of weird things going on down there, like that mirror and the cave with the treasures in. You know, you could look in the mirror and you could see the past as well as the future. I'm not making this up, guys. I saw it.
I did too.
Honey, listen. We all believe that you think you saw a cave full of treasures. There's got to be a reasonable explanation.
What, Chief Bennett?
Well,
you know, I smell gas when the shaft collapsed.
So did I.
And the gas could have caused Charity to pass out, and Miguel and Kay to hallucinate.
Noxious gases have been known to make people imagine all kinds of things.
Reese is right.
I'm not imagining the box with the light.
Yeah, and St. Michael was there with a sword.
Look, if we could show you the box, would you believe us then?
I certainly hope you're not planning to go down there again.
Look, nobody is going anywhere. Okay, Luis and Reese hit on the explanation. All right, I think we all need a good night's sleep. We'll sort this out in the morning.
I can't believe Julian's the only one who didn't make it out. Julian?
He looks terrible. Eve, can you come over here and take a look at him?
Sam,
I think he wants to tell you something.
Me?
Well, go see what he wants.
Of my life kissing you.
Well, what about eating and sleeping and working? Little things like that.
I don't care about those things. The only thing I care about is being with you.
I am gonna kill her.
No. No, you don't want to risk a showdown now when you're doing so well.
But I am the one who's supposed to have the first day and she's kissing him right under my nose.
Gwen, get a grip. All she has are two hot-to-trot little lips. You have everything else. You have your brains, your body, and your class. All the things that Ethan loves about you. And you use them. And in no time at all, you will be Mrs. Ethan Crane. And she will be Teresa Who.
As much as I'd like to stay, it wouldn't be fair to Gwen. Sleep tight, Teresa.
I will, because I will be dreaming of you. Dream of me, too. Just stay strong. Don't let him know you saw him.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Teresa's still a little insecure about the whole dating thing.
No, that's funny. She doesn't strike me as the insecure type.
Well, she'll be okay. She's a firm believer in fate.
So am I. The only difference is I believe in making my own.
I know gas can affect people's brains,
Right, but what I saw down there was real. And the light that came out of that box was more powerful than anything I've ever seen. It almost killed Charity.
You saved my life, didn't you?
I'd never let anything happen to you.
Hey, thanks for saving the love of my life, too.
I don't care what anyone says. I wasn't hallucinating down there. I know what I saw, and Charity was trying to kill Miguel.
That doesn't make sense.
I know, but she did. And I'm gonna find out why. Miguel told me that if Charity hadn't come to Harmony, we'd be together right now. He even kissed me.
Now I know you're hallucinating.
I swear to God.
All right, whatever you say. But I have my own problems. Chad has never left Whitney's side since we all almost fell down the mine shaft. I think they're getting a little bit too close.
Okay. We've got our work cut out for us. You've got to get Chad away from your sister, and I have to get rid of you-know-who.
Hurry, Princess! Timmy wants to go home. Stop rushing me, lad. I've had a very trying evening. Timmy's the one that got run over by the minecart.
Yes, but you're fine now, whereas I still have a huge problem. Remember, Charity has to kill Miguel in order for me to get my powers back. Now that the pendant's been destroyed, I have to come up with an entire new plan.
I can't believe you're still here.
I would like nothing more than to be on my way back to Paris, but I cannot leave until you eliminate Sheridan.
Well, I'll try not to keep you waiting long, okay?
Well, he's in and out of consciousness right now, but all his other vital signs are good.
Sam!
What do you want, Julian?
Don't try to talk, Julian. You're too weak.
Ivy. Tramp.
I wonder why Julian would call Ivy a tramp.
Night, Teresa.
Good night, Gwen.
Don't worry so much. I mean, que sera, sera, no? Isn't that what fate's all about?
So you did it again, Chad.
What you mean, saving you from that mine shaft? I'd have done that for any girl I was crazy about.
Come on, guys. Let's go home.
Chad, I'm so tired. You may have to carry me.
Okay.
Come on.
Tabitha. Look, I don't really remember any of it, but I just wanted to thank you for getting us all out of that mine shaft.
Oh, anytime, dear.
And look, I heard what Kay said, and I know that you would never hurt any of us. Just as much as I know I wouldn't.
I couldn't have said it better myself.
Thank you. Oh, Tabitha, your face is like ice.
Oh, must be the damp night air.
Will you go home and get warm, okay?
She's back! Timmy's sweet Charity's finally back!
Not for long, dollface. I have to get my powers back ASAP.
But how?
It's me. I'm worried about that damnable box full of goodness and light. You saw how it pulverized the pendant. If anybody gets that lid off, we'll be next.
Look, nobody's gonna believe us unless we show them the box from the mine shaft.
I know, but how can we? It's buried down there.
I don't care. I'm going back down to get it.
I know you don't have much use for him.
Well, he is your brother. You should go look after him.
can't believe that Julian would call his own wife a tramp. He must be out of it from the fall. You have got to do something and get Julian out of here before he says something else.
What are you talking about?
He called me a tramp. He knows about me and love.
How did he find out?
What difference does it make? I'm just going to keep denying it, no matter what he says. But the point is, I'm afraid he's going to put two and two together and figure out that Ethan is Sam's son. And he's going to destroy Ethan's future.
Oh, I don't give a damn about that. But I do care about Grace finding out. Just kill her to find out any of this.
Then help me, Eve, before he says something and believe me, all hell will break loose.